Hello, Algebra 1 students, and welcome back to your Semester 2 final review. Today we're looking at problem 37, which, although it's actually really addressed throughout a lot of topics, probably the best video for it is lesson 10.6. This question is asking us about the axis of symmetry and the maximum value of our function. So, a few things we need to realize. First, what's going to help us most understand what this question is asking is a very rough sketch of this parabola. Now we know it's a parabola, there's a square, and we also know that there's a negative value here. So what I'm going to do is quickly sketch this in, okay? And it's not going to be perfect. I'm really only going to add a couple things on here. I know that this parabola is downward facing. And I also know that the y-intercept, right, if you replace the x's with 0, I know the y-intercept is negative 16. This really gives me two options. Either my graph is going to look like this, or my graph is going to look like this, and I honestly don't know which one, so I'm just going to assume this and go from here. All right, so here's my parabola. Now, let's re-ask the question, but in pieces. What is the axis of symmetry? Well, the axis of symmetry is that line that goes straight through. What point does it go through on the parabola? Oh, right, it goes through the vertex, right? So if we can find the vertex, something, comma, something, we'll know the axis of symmetry. And then they also want to know the maximum value. Well, the maximum value is the top of the parabola. That's also the vertex. So actually, this question is really find the vertex and find the vertex of this function. So what do you think we should do? Yeah, we should probably find the vertex. So this function to me looks like it is in standard form. And although there are two ways to find the vertex in standard form, we're only going to look at one of them because the second way is a bit of a struggle. The second way would have us find the zeros first, the x-intercepts, by setting the equation equal to 0. And you could solve, and this might factor, it might not. I don't actually know off the top of my head. And then you could find the zeros, and then once you find the zeros, you find what's in between the zeros, and that gives you part of the vertex, and then you substitute that back into the equation to find the other part. But luckily, now that we know the quadratic formula and we've watched lesson 10.5, we know a shortcut to find the vertex that's linked to the quadratic formula. So I'm going to remind you of the quadratic formula. Negative boy, couldn't make up his mind, b square, miss out on four awesome chicks, all over 2a. There we go. And in 10.5, to find a nice formula for the vertex, we just went through and we added these two solutions together. And what we found is it canceled out the square root and left us with this other piece. And in fact, we learned that to find the h value of the vertex, all we need is the formula negative b divided by 2a. So let's go ahead and take our standard form equation, identify a, that's our negative 2, and identify b, which is positive 12, and let's substitute those values in. So negative b over 2 times a, where b was 12, don't forget the negative out front, most common mistake my students make, over negative 2. Simplifying this, negative 12 divided by negative 4 seems to be positive 3. Oh good, I guessed well so far. My vertex is going to be 3, comma, something. And in fact, I think this is enough to find the answer to the problem because we already know the x, and the axis of symmetry goes to the x-axis. So the axis of symmetry is x equals 3. It always matches the h value of our vertex. So which one has the right axis of symmetry? Well, that is certainly b. However, we should understand the maximum value as well. So there's one more thing needed here. We need to find the k value. So, k value, we take our original equation, and we are going to replace the x's with what? Well, if we know the h is 3, we should probably replace the x's with 3. And that will find the output when x is 3. I forgot my square here, common mistake. So, you can put all this in your calculator if you would like. I will just follow SADMEP. There was nothing to do with any of the parentheses, so I did the exponent. Now I'll tackle that multiplication. And then we'll start adding and subtracting. And I think we find that k is 2. Wow, my parabola is actually quite accurate. I'm pretty proud of myself here. So We learned in 10.6 that when they ask for the minimum or the maximum value, they mean the highest our parabola gets. And the highest our parabola gets is 2. It is equivalent to the k value or the y value of the vertex. So we can see the 2 that's right here. In fact, if you put these two together, 3 comma 2, you get the overall vertex. The axis of symmetry is the h, the maximum value is the 2. Notice they would have asked you for a minimum value if this had been a positive out front, because then our parabola would have looked like this, and there would have been a minimum instead of a maximum. But the process is the same, you're really just finding the vertex. Hopefully this did a nice job explaining both the axis of symmetry and the maximum value. As always, for more information, you can go back to 10.6, and I'm excited to continue to help you succeed on your final exam for semester 2.